Dear friends, Honorable Supreme Court in Lalit Kumar Jain versus Union of India delivered a landmark judgment. This judgment is going to strengthen this insolvency and bankruptcy code. What is the judgment? The judgment says very clearly in single terms. What is the issue that was brought to the notice of the Supreme Court as a challenge? The Union of India, MC, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, issued a notification wherein the personal guarantors, corporate guarantors, become liable for insolvency proceedings, bankruptcy proceedings. Section 78, 79 and 148 to 192, all those provisions come into play. Let me tell you the short point, then I'll go back to it. The issue is very simple. I am a promoter of a company. I have taken loan from the banks 100 crores. I also gave personal guarantee. Corporate guarantee I have given to the company, to the bank, for giving loan to the bank, my company. They have taken surety from me, from my wife, my children. This is it. Now, somebody where I didn't pay money above 1 lakh, now 1 crore, they have filed a case under Section 7 if it is a financial creditor. Under Section 9, if it is a operational creditor, Section 10, voluntary. When you know, when this resolution proceeding starts, which is called as corporate insolvency resolution process, first thing what happens is, one resolution professional, who is called as first month interim resolution professional, next is resolution professional, will come into play. And they will form committee of creditors, that invariably bankers. So it is a creditor controlled process. That means what is the risk in this first game? The risk in the first game is the promoter who is holding control of the company gets displaced. The board of directors get displaced. And in person, a resolution professional comes into the picture. And the committee of creditors, by majority of 66%, they will be calling for meetings and all. It is literally creditors driven proceedings. So there was no incentive for a promoter to become like this. But what happened during the course of these things? Synergy Dure came in. Synergy Dure, what happened? They have taken 100 crore, 1000 crores from bankers. And that promoters themselves taken over the company. They gave a resolution plan and then they said we'll pay 6% is what written. 6 crores they have given and then they took over the company. So what happened? That is, word is called as haircut. The new word was coined as haircut. So let us say 1000 crores company, by paying 100 crores, that too just 10 crores now, same promoter has taken. That became great incentive for them. Even though this legislation was there, it was not enacted. Both had been enacted simultaneously, things would have been very good. But what happened? All the promoters thought, this is a very good legislation. Actually, we don't need to pay the banks. Why should you do all these things? We are cleared of all these liabilities. Now, then after some 2 years, they realized, all promoters are doing like this. Then parliament met and then passed an ordinance saying 29A ineligibility came. That means what happened, friends? BLRC, Banking Law Reforms Committee, was supposed to come out with experts sitting. First thing they should do is, in India, whenever income tax legislation comes, the assessees try to evade it. Whenever these recovery proceedings come, the affected party will find ways and means to come out of the law. And basically they should have protected that. They did not do it. that's called experts committee. Then this IBBI is empowered to continue. 2 years they were praising, and parliament has come into picture. But the problem is IBBI, every time they will go to media and claim credits. Even today, not even one media asked the question, why are you claiming credit? What happened? What is the object of this legislation? The object of the legislation is revival, resolution, not liquidation. What happened? 97% companies went into liquidation. Have you achieved the object? Two, it should be in a time-bound manner. What happened to time-bound manner? 270 days, they increased to 330 days. Now it will be 700 days, 800 days minimum. That also you lost. Then what is maximum realization? Nothing. The haircut is 6,50,000 crores gone against 8,20,000 crores. So what have you achieved? Loss of employment, workers, everything. It is like our Prime Minister claiming, we won, India won COVID. I am the leader of the world. What happened? Millions have died. This is same publicity driven issues. By now, we should have made the chairperson responsible. It's a business legislation. What is the problem with this legislation? Nobody knows hands-on experience in reviving companies, right from the chairperson, who is an academic person, who is a company secretary. We are not telling you should have been online to revive a company, then only the legislations would have been workable. Okay. So at least the Supreme Court has very clearly said, in case CARP process only 30 crores is received by the bankers, balance 70 crores are out, haircut only to the corporate debtor. Normal law is very clear. When the corporate debtor to which I gave surety is absolved, then I am also absolved. That is Contract Act. This is beautifully analyzed by Honorable Adjudicating Authority Prakash Kumar Sir, who is now the president of NCLT. Wonderful, wonderful judge. His judgments are, 2 years back I was sitting in his court when the issue came. The issue is frontline hospitals. The resolution, the voting was done, and it was 230 voting to 75% creditors voted in favor of the proposal. And South Indian Bank, dissenting creditor, secured creditor, refused. They did not vote for it. So issue number one arose is, when I don't decide, this is not a resolution, CARP process is not there, is it? When I dissent it, what is my position? I am a secured creditor. What about the Contract Act? Lordships, Honorable Prakash Kumar, analyzed the whole thing. What is the concept of voting, majority? In case of COC in existence, majority is 66%. In case of compromise arrangement, 75%. And in case of 12A proposal, 90%. This is agreed. What is majority defined by the act? Suppose 66% agree and 33% don't agree. They have right in a democratic setup, they can agree or disagree. But once majority is there, the minority should go with them. That is the rule of law. First point number one, he declared. Next question arises is, what is Contract Act versus IBC? He gave answer for it. IBC is a special legislation. Far-reaching powers. What is the object of IBC? Resolution. Recovery. No. Revival. So here is a sick company has come to resolution. You appoint somebody. Till such time another good person comes to take over. That is why you displace the promoters, directors. That means new person is coming. He is trying to revive. If today is loss, once you revive, it will become profit. There are companies which 2 rupees, 3 rupees share value are now going at 3000 rupees. Understand? Because when the company is in life, you can do wonders. But when you are going to go by death of liquidation, what is there? It is dead and gone. So therefore, he said that is different legislation. whereas Contract Act is a different law. In a Contract Act, what is a contract? It's an agreement between two persons. Now I gave you loan for 10 lakhs and I'm not able to recover, I'm in need. You say I'll give you 5 lakhs. Full and final settlement I'll give. That's all. That is a voluntary act. Whereas this one is driven by law, legislation. Therefore, he said, you South Indian Bank, you have every right. You can go and recover it as and when the personal guarantees are involved. Fine. Friends, now, what is the impact on the banking profitability, friends? The first step is, these, whatever I said, 1,820,000 crores, the bankers would have already provided in their books. The profitability is after providing these provisions. Now, a windfall will come to the bankers because of this law, if it is implemented well. That means there should be some better controls on IBBI. They are just going on passing, attacking the resolution professional. Nothing else they are doing. So, bankers are going to do, public sector banks will do very well. Now, second is, business discipline will increase. You know, today I am a person, what is the incentive for me? Reviving is better for me than taking away. Earlier means 1000 crores I have taken, I will pay 50 crores, 950 crores I will write off. That money I will use and start another business. It was a great incentive to default. But today there is no incentive for default. And therefore, if this law is implemented well, because if experience, no research has been done, that is the problem for us. No data is there. We don't believe in science. We only believe in other things. You know, Corona has come. What did you believe? Tali, Diya, Popo, go, they are telling. Science is more important. But we people are peculiar Indians. That's different. Let us hope. At least we think rationally. Understand, what is the logic? What is the incentive for me to do frauds? But earlier, friends, why there is a delay, you know? The promoter thinks, 1000 crore company, I will bring somebody. Now 29 years, earlier I used to come inside. Now 29 years come, after some time, till then everybody enjoyed. Now I will bring somebody through me. And most delays are because of the promoters. They keep on giving 12-year proposal with the 12-year proposal. And you know, the bankers are there. Public sector bankers are recovery persons. They are about to retire, most of them. I am not saying all, very good, honest people are there. But there is no place in banking system for honest people. They will be killed. So they will know what, if you take decision only in banks, public sector, there is a problem. If you don't take decision, there is no problem. So nobody takes decision. And resolution professional don't know anything. He would have been a retired banker. He has not got any experience. That's all. So I hope this will not act as an incentive, and professionals are charging money, lakhs of rupees. Lakhs of rupees they charge for one appearance, two appearance. Why all these things? Had the law been corrected, you read my old videos, I have analyzed with practical examples, I told what is happening, simple things to be solved. Thank you, friends, a very good judgment. We should thank the Honorable Supreme Court for relying upon what Honorable Prakash Kumar sir very beautifully explained. But NCLAT took a different stand. That was cut down and it's gone to